What's up guys, welcome to another video. My name is Sparkman, I'm a game developer. Yes, I want to show you a new feature of AGK2. Let's go to DLC and let's open the visual editor. So AGK2 now has a visual editor. Here we can open a project or we can start a new project. I want to call this one Sparkman. And here we go. Okay, let's see what we got here. We got media, scene, create text, make the text bigger. I want to make this Sparkman just because we can. That's not too bad there. Let's see, let's change the color, change it to purple. Of course, how do you change the background color? Check out the scene settings. Okay, and let's make it blue. That works. Whoa, that's hard to see. Let me see, change that to something. There you go, much better. Okay, so we don't have any sprites. Let's see, let's import something. Let's try this potion bottle. Drag it into the screen. We can scale it. Whoa, it scales really good. It doesn't blur. And you can rotate. And no blurred. Wow. Impressive. What happens if you press the play button? Okay, it sends you back to AGK2. Let me run this. Whoa, and there is our battle. Very nice. Very nice. Let me see. What else we got here? Drag another potion. I'm gonna drag two more. Okay, we can snap to grid, we can view grid. It doesn't snap to grid, but I just seen a snap to grid that time. Snap to grid. Okay, so these bottles are 100 by 100. So maybe we can set the grid size to 100 by 100. Let's see. Much better. We have like four bottles on the screen. So let's see, let me bring in a background. There is my background. Obviously not big enough. Let me turn off snap to grid. Let's make it bigger. And now we have one small problem. Let's send this to back. There we go. Let's run this. And there is our background. Wow. Now this is really hard to see. Let me change that to another color. Change it to red or pink or something. So this is called Sprite Zero. Okay, this is Sprite 1, 3, 2. Maybe swap them. There you go. Now they're in order. Let me go to the editor and let's see how we target the sprites. Okay, alright, okay, this is how you target the sprites. Let me just copy this. So we can paste that before the div. That's gonna load the sprite from the visual editor. Let's see if this works. Let me just set sprite position. The sprite is going to be this one here. And it's gonna be 0, 0, which is X and Y. Okay, so let's run this. Okay, sprite one is gonna show up at 0 there, but it's already at 0 there, so let me see. Enable the grid again. What does here down here? So let's target this one here, sprite 0. Put it down here. And let's see, we're gonna target sprite 0. And let's run this. Okay, that works. It repositions the sprite. Now you don't have to call it sprite ID here. You can call this anything you like. I can just call this, I don't know, what can I call this? Something funny. Just gonna call it red one. Okay. Or wine. There we go. Wine. Okay, wine 0. And here you have to call it wine 0 as well. Here we go, run it, try it out, and it works the same way. So that's how we load the sprites from the editor. I'm gonna make a variable, I'm gonna call it HH. gonna set it to 300, and let's make it so if HH equals HH minus 1, this will decrease this variable every millisecond. So let's set the Y position of this to HH. Let's run this, and you can see that we can easily target those sprites. You can do it for the X position as well. Whoa! Very good, very good. Now that's just a quick example how to target the sprites in the editor. Okay, so now this comes with a few templates. So let me show you. This comes with this Jewel template. Very professional graphics. Now this also has scenes. Now this one doesn't have scenes, but let me show you another example that has scenes. Try a jumping jack. Scene 2 is the title. Now you can change the scenes here in AGK2. So let me see, this is scene 3 and scene 4. So you can make a lot of, so you can make labels very simple. All you have to do is click this button here, and then you have a new scene. Now this have no code, okay, it's just a template for you to work it out, but a lot of these projects already have the code here to get you started. Let's run this. You can see that this editor makes life a lot easier. Something I like about the AGK is that it's not a very heavy engine. Okay, so you can load this very quickly. You can make games on a laptop with this, no problem. It doesn't have to be like a fast laptop or anything. Okay guys, give it a try. I will leave a link down in the description below. Thanks for watching, and I will see you in the next episode. Bye now.